Hello students, hope you all are fine at your home. So today in this video lecture, I will be discussing first chapter of class 6 science, that is food, where does it comes from. Before starting, I will suggest you to listen the video very carefully, and if you want to copy down the notes, you can do it later on. You can write the notes in rough copy or loose sheet if class 2 copy is not available to you. Now come to the chapter. The topics which we are going to cover are food and its importance, food variety and ingredients of food, food material and sources, types of animal on the basis of their food habit, food chain and food web, steps to avoid wastage of food. Now coming to the first topic, that is food. A simple definition of food is a substance which is eaten daily to provide energy to our body. Now the importance of food are it provide energy to the body. Yes. If we do not eat food, we will not be able to do our daily activities like studying, running, walking, playing, etc. Secondly, it helps in growth and development of our body. Yes, if we do not take proper food, our growth and development will be hampered. Thirdly, it protects us from different kinds of diseases and thus keep us healthy. Yes, if any time we fall sick, we go to doctor. Doctor, along with the medicine, advise us to take healthy food, which help us to cure very fast. And lastly, all living things require food for their survival. It is most important that all living things need food for their survival. Now, coming to the next topic, it is food variety. There are two types of food which are available around us. It is raw and cooked food. Raw are those food which can be eaten without cooking, example cucumber, apple, radish, etc. And cooked, they are to be cooked and spices are added before eating. It includes pulses, meat, etc. Now coming to ingredients of food. Cooked food consists of various material which are called its ingredients. We have taken two examples over here, dal and kheer. For preparing dal, we require pulses, water, spices, which includes turmeric and salt. And for preparing kheer, we require milk, rice, sugar, cardamom pods and dry food. So here you can see the ingredients vary according to the food item which we are preparing. Now, food habits of people. Some food habits of people of different states are given below. So you can see that different food habits of different peoples of different state is mentioned over here. How does the food habit of people are affected? Simply, they are affected by the food production and supply of food at that particular place. Now coming to the first, we see Tamil Nadu. Here, people prefer to eat rice, sambar, rasam, idli, dosa. Then come to Punjab and Haryana. Here, people prefer to eat paratha, pulses, rice, makke ki roti, sarso ka saag. Then come to Rajasthan. People here eat bajra, dalia, chapati, dal, kachori. In Gujarat, people eat chapati, rice, dal, thepla, dhokla, etc. And in Andhra Pradesh, you can find people prefer to eat upma, dosa, rasam, curd, rice, dry vegetables, etc. And in Maharashtra, people food habit are pav bhaji, vada pav, puran puli, etc. So this is the food habit of the people. Now coming to the next topic, it is food material and sources. There are food sources can be derived from two main group, that is plants and animal. First one is plant. They are also called producers or autotrophs because they can make their own food. Second is animals. They are called as consumer or heterotrophs because they cannot make their own food. They depend on other plants and animals for their food. Now we will take one by one both the things in detail. First of all, plant as a source of food. Yes. Plants, as you know, have different parts, and different parts of the plant can be eaten. Firstly, we see roots. Root, example, beetroot, radish, carrot. Then come leaves, which is spinach, lettuce, cabbage. Then it is stem, which includes potato, sugarcane, onion, ginger, etc. Flower, which includes broccoli, pumpkin, etc. And fruits, which is liked by everyone, it is mango, papaya, orange, etc. So these are the different parts of the plant which we use as source of our food. Now coming to the next, animal as a source of food. From animals also we get different varieties of food, such as meat and chicken, eggs, milk. From milk we get different milk products like curd, paneer, butter, etc. And next is honey, which is obtained from honeybee. Now let us know about detailed preparation of honey. Honeybee suck the nectar from the flower of the plant. Then after, they modify or change the nectar inside the body to make honey. This honey prepared is stored in beehive. In this way, honey is prepared. Now something more you should know about honey is, honey comprises of water, sugar, minerals and enzymes. Next, it is used as antiseptic. Yes, whenever you are having cough and cold, you must have seen that your mother giving you honey along with tulsi leaf to eat daily in the morning, so that you can recover very fast. And lastly, rearing of honeybee on a large scale is called apiculture. Now, what is the meaning of rearing? Rearing means care and management of honeybee for the production of honey. Okay, so these are the animals as a source of food. Now, on the basis of eating habits of people, they are categorized into three types. First is non-vegetarian. By saying the word non-vegetarian, I am sure you must have understood what I am going to say. Yes, people who eat meat, chicken, egg, fish, prawn, etc. in addition to plant products are known as non-vegetarian. Next is vegetarian. People who eat only plant products are vegetarian, but they too consume animal products such as milk, cheese, curd, ghee and honey. These two, I hope must have been clear to you, non-vegetarian and vegetarian. Now come to the third group, they are known as vegans, V-E-G-A-N-S, vegans. There are people who eat only vegetarian diet that excludes milk and dairy products. And all animal derived ingredients like honey, such people are called vegans. They also refrain from eating refined white sugar as it is processed using animal products. So let me explain you about vegans. Vegans are those people, they are only vegetarian. Okay, and they do not even eat milk and dairy product. They will be only eating vegetarian diet. And one more thing it is mentioned over here, they also refrain from eating refined white sugar as it is processed from animal product. Why it is so? We all know that sugar is obtained from sugar cane. But this white sugar, you would have seen cake, the icing of sugar which is done on cake, it contains dried egg white. That is why they refrain, means they avoid using white sugar. Okay, so student, this much for today. Now I'll be giving you some questions as your homework, which will also be uploaded on your parents portal. Here are 6 questions which you need to do in your rough copy, loose sheet or plaster copy, whichever is available to you. And if you are having any queries, if you want to ask any question, you can upload these questions on parent portals. Thank you students. Stay healthy, stay safe and stay at your home. I will upload the next video very soon. Thank you.